Hi, my name's Juliet, and today is the third in a series of videos about collections in Scrivener 3 for Windows. I promised you non-editing reasons for creating collections today. So, the first way I ever used collections was to create different ebook versions of my manuscript for different retailers. Another way you could use this technique is if you want to keep a collection of books in one Scrivener file, say a trilogy. You could have a different collection set up for each book with appropriate front and back matter, which would enable you to create a separate book for each volume and an omnibus edition from the same Scrivener file. Now, when you go into Compile over on the right where you see your manuscript, under the Compile pull-down menu, you can see your collections. Select the one you need and select the appropriate front and back matter. All that remains then is to compile your book. Let's look at a specific non-fiction option. If you write the type of non-fiction where you customise for different clients, you could have all the sections you need in your binder with appropriate front and back matter and create collections to produce customised books. You may even be able to have standard collection options and just change the front and back matter depending on who it's for and depending on how you work. Can you think of any other reasons for using collections? Put them in the comments if you have them. Thanks for watching, and if you subscribed, I'll see you again next time.